So again, his was the 8, R is 8% superior, M is the rating or the compounding periods, M12. It's required to find the I. I should write here, and let's see, I would say AFIC. Just press that one and it asks me for the rate. The rate is 8%, 0.08. And N, there is N peri, not per. It means that you have to input the value of M, compounding frequency. And here's the compound frequency 12, because I'm going to find the value per I effective. So here's the I effective is 8, and you can increase the digits by doing this. Okay, so it's 8.3. So remember, we use this one for having N peri. Now, the second one, I wanted to share this one with you. So if I have the effective rate was 9% per year, so it means that I have the I effect per year. And the compounding was weekly. Weekly, it means how much weeks that we have. So you have to compare. So what is the required? The required is R. So basically, the I effective is equal to 1 plus R over M power M minus 1. This M here, we have this one. It's how much? 9% per year. So M, it should be how much is the frequency compounding weekly. So we have year, we have weekly. So M is equal to how much weeks that we have in 1 year. So how much weeks that we have in 1 year? Hello?
48.
We have 12 months.
So it is 48 weeks.
Yeah, 48 times 2, 4. So it's equal to 48 weeks. So yeah, but we have another 4 weeks that are, because we have 12 months, that's working weeks. Okay, but we have 12 times 2 days in each one, which is equal to 24 days, and this 24 days divided by 7 means that we have another three to four. So we can say we have 52. This is, look at this one, this is usual, normal. But the 48 is the one that we are using in our accounting. So again, what I want to see, I want to see how much is the value of the nominal rate, the R here. So what I should write, I have I effective, 1 plus the R is missing, M is equal to 48, power 48, minus 1. And this is will be 9% per year. So this is the weeks that we have in 1 year. Now just find one equation and you can find the only R that we have, or we can use this nominal rate, function. How to do that? Just we have to go to the Excel sheet and we say that, okay, I effective is equal to 9%, and M is equal to 48. So how much is the R? Now, I will say, I should go to the cell, I will say this is equal to normal, nominal. Look at the nominal, the first command appears to a nominal. It asks me how much is the effective rate. In my case, the effective rate is 9%, so I should write it as a 0.09, right? How much is the N period? Here's the N period is 48. And look at this one. So I get the R, which is 8.6% per one. Also, we have learned that we have, again, we have another two. We have another two comments extra. One is called effective, and one is called nominal. Nominal is to find the effective is to find the I effective. Nominal is to find the rate R. So what we should need here, we should need the I effective, we should need R, comma N peri. Here's M, R rate. Here we need to what, if you want to find the nominal rate, we need I effective, and we need also N peri. I effective and M. So we have to learn, we have another two comments here in the list of the comments. Okay, so be aware about how to write them, write the comments and how to write them. So we have, because it's very important, and there will be a question about the using of the comments in the midterm and even in the final. Look at this one. We have in this, when I'm going to, let me say, I'm going to deposit a certain amount of money in my account, for example, in every month. So I am going to count to pay to the month fair. So this is called payment period. Just I want, so sometimes you will receive money benefits, sometimes you have to pay. So the minimum period, the minimum one here is we have every month. So what we have here is called a period of payment. So there is a 1 month payment, there is a minimum. So the shortest one. So 1 month is equal to the time that I did my payment. Now, the time that your fortune has been calculated for, let me say, the business that you are going to count how much is the interest is there, they are going to count it for you every 6 months. This is called compounding period. So we have two things. We have payment period, either you have to receive or you have to pay money. But the CP is the compounded. This is what related to the economy, the amount of the interest that there will be for the calculations. Here's every 6 months, there will be one chance that there will be a calculation for the transaction there will be for the fortune. But you are going, you are almost paying for 6 times, then after the 6 months, there will be. This is called CP, this is called PP. So CP is the compounding period, and PP is the payment period. Payment, you maybe you are receiving, you are already, so a single payment. So payment PP is for a single payment. Now, what I should, why I want them, I want these two terms because I want to compare between them, whether the PP payment period and CP compounding period at equal, or the payment period is greater than the CP, or the compounding period is greater than the payment period. Then after that, I should calculate the single amount of the uniform gradient that we have and go to find the effective rate for that one. Let me bring an example for you for this one. So the question is, if you have payment period is greater than a compound period, means that you are going to invest your money for now, and you want to see how much it will be after a period, for example, 1 year, and it's compounding every month. So the payment period PP was 1 year. You paid a single amount and you want to check for 1 year, but the compounding period was 1 month, every month. So here we have payment period greater than the compounding period for this case. You wanna find the value of P or F anyhow. So what you have to do is to use the effective rate. You have to use the effective rate. You should use I effect. This is in case that we have for a single or series payment, you have to use the effective rate and so on. Now, for example, find the equivalent F. I want to see how much is the value of F in 10 years. If P was 1,000, I paid $1,000 now. I want to see how much it will be in 10 years. This is 10, it is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And the R, or the nominal rate, is equal to 12 percentage per year, compounded semi-annually. Semi-annually, it means every 6 months there was a compound. This is compound period. Now, compound period is equal to 6 months, and payment period was for 1 year. Now, what we have, what payment period is equal to greater than the CP. So we should use our effective rate in our calculations. So this R is percentage per year. I want it to be effective rate. So I want to see I effective per year. So I have R per year. So how to do that? I will just write this is I effective is equal to that R, which is 12 percentage per year, divided by 2, because 2 times there will be compounding, power 2 minus 1, and it becomes how much? 12 divided by 2, it's 0.6, 0.06. So 1.06 power 2 minus 1. So it becomes 12.1236 percentage per year, or it means 12.36 percentage per year. So what I should do, I will just say that the value of F, here's this value, is equal to the value of P times a factor. The factor is I have P, I want F for N equal to 10 years, and I equal to, how much is the value of I? I should equal to I effective, which is the 12.36%. This is the difference. This is if it was not saying that this is compounded every 6 months, so you should use all directly the 12%. But you are using the 12.36% because it asks you, say that this is not a regular one, it's a compounding period. Do you have any problem with this one?
No.
Have you understand what I'm talking about? Okay.
Yes, yes.
Yeah. So the main idea is to use, look at the compounding period and the PP. Payment period. The payment period is greater than this is means you have to use the not a regular interest rate. You have to use effective interest rate per year. So 10 years, yes, effective rate should be per year. So I'm using the I rate per year, and I convert it to find effectively per semi-annually. So it will be look like this. And after that, we have an equation formula for this. The formula for this is say that $1,000 times 1 plus I is 12.36 power 10 years. This is will be the, let me say plus 1 power 10 So it becomes 3.2. This is will be 3.3207. So 1,000 times it means $3,207. This is the account that the amount that I have it after 10 years. It will be the 1,000 will become make a fortune for $3,207. Effectively, this is was because every 6 months there was a transaction. Now, there is another idea to solve this one. Alternative idea, here's the alternative idea, is to use the Excel sheet that we see. We have R, we have, this is N, so we can use the one that is here. Okay. Look at this one example. We have Boeing has purchased composite wing fixtures and assembly for of its new Dreamliner commercial airline. Assume this system is cost. It means this is cost. This is P. The P is worth $3 million, the system. And it needs to install money. It is needs to install per year. How much it needs? $200,000. So $200,000 every per 1 year is required just to what? So just these are the costs. So that's why I'm drawing them down. So I need $3 million just to install this one, and also I need every year to $200,000 for if all these all installation over 10 years. Now I buy this system $3 million plus $200,000 every year for 10 years. Now what is the point for that? The point is to have benefit from using the system. You say that so we want to calculate for every 6 months at least. Every 6 months, how much is the value of the revenue from the system should come just to cover all the costs that we have. So every 6 months, I'm doing my calculation and I want to see how much it. So here's the A. This A is the benefit that is required to be for every 6 months is required from the company to take into account to find how much at least. This is at least to just cover the costs that we have. Now, what should I do? Just first of all, these all amounts are costs. So these are the benefits. I will go and I will make them equal. How to do that? I will bring all the costs here to one point, and I will bring all the benefits here to one point. And then in one point, I will say, okay, the benefits in year one and should be equal to the costs in year one. To do that, firstly, I will just focus on the cost. So we have, look at the I, look at this one, a value of 8% compounded semi-annual. Look at this one. This I is 8%, but it's not normal. It's normally, it should be per year, but it's per year, but it's accounted semi-annually. It means that when I want to $200,000 here, I want, this is A. When I want to convert this A to make it as a P and add them to the $3 million as a total value of the cost, I should consider the value of the 8% effective needed, not that one. So affected needed is to find how much is that one it will become. So I 8%, I want I affected for that 8%, it's equal to 1 plus. This I, it's 0.08. This is normal. Counted semi-annually, it means M equal to 2 and power 2 minus 1. Let me see this one. It will become 1.04 power 2 minus 1. So it's 0.0816, which means 8.16 percentage per year. So when I am doing my calculation for this one, so I should consider the I equal to 18.16, not 8 only. So what I should do, I will just say, so remember that I effective is equal to 8.16 percentage per year. So I'm going to say for the whole courses that I have, I will say, okay, costs that we have $3 million, so $3 million have been paid in the beginning, plus also I have every year $200,000 payment, so $200,000 payment. This is A, and I want to add them to the $3 million. How to do that? By converting it to P. How to convert this one? I will do, this is A. I want to convert it to P. For how many years? For 10 years. But remember, for which I? The I here is equal to? Hello?
8.16.
Ah, very good. 8.16 percentage per year. This is will be all the courses that we have. And by the way, we don't have the table for 8.16. So what is the, what to do? We can use a formula or we can use the equation. After that, I have all the costs. Okay, so I have a number. Now go back to this, to the part of the, this is cost. For the benefits that we have, and I have a value of A, which I don't know how much is it, but I want to see how much is this A will become equal, because you cannot say, oh, we have to say the total cost and the total benefits in year zero. So I don't have its A, but I will write it as a symbol. And now I have to convert all the A's that we have. A, I want to make it as a P. For N equal, look at this one. I have every 6 months payment receiving from the bank, from the account. So for 10 years, how much times that I have, I should have A? Every year there will be two A. There will be two amount of revenue. That's what I'm looking for. So I have 10 years times two, there will be N. So there will be 20 A's, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. There will be 20 times of revenue of payments. I will receive them just to cover this one. And now I, in each one, because this one, and here's 20 years, but in each one we have 8% per year. How much it will be per 6 months? It will be 4% per one period. So look at this one here. I have this one. I have from the table 20, I number 4, I can't find this. So we have, I will make them equal and equal in the cost and the benefits. It will give you a value of A, which one unknown. This A will represent a value, a minimum revenue value to just cover the costs, the $3 million that will be in the beginning, and also every $200,000 for every year's cost. So, yeah, so for this one, yes, the total cost that was there, it was $4,332,000. $1,000 was the total value of the courses by using what? By using this 18.16. Now the next is for the 20 payments, the 20 revenues that we have based on 8% per year will equal to 4% per half semi-annual. So I can use this one and I have it as an A. So I want to convert it to A. So here's A is the minimum value, is the minimum value that we have, 318,775 dollars is required just to cover the 3 million and the $200. So remember that this is was 3 million. This is what 3 million. This is was $200,000. So we have to have 375,000 something dollars just to cover all the values. More than this value, it will give you more revenue for having the system. This is an idea how to use the nominal and the effective rates. Be careful to how to use them, and I will leave the this example for you. I want you to solve this one. And by the way, leave this example, not required for you, leave it. Leave this one because there's another things here. We don't want to make cycles. The cycles will be in chapter 4, okay? Do you have any question regarding the nominal and effective rates? I want you to carefully read the chapter whole and to watch the video again. And we will be continuing for this one. And I will send you today assignment number 1 and the due date for the assignment. I think it's Wednesday. So please, if you have anything before or you want to ask me anything during the you are going to solve this one, ask. I will be ready for answering. Okay. Was it clear to you all the slides and the video?
Yes, sir. Thank you.
Okay. Take your time and thank you for attending the lecture. See you.
You too, sir. Have a good day.
Have a nice day. Yes, thank you. Jeev, please try to send me the file.
Sir, I tried to send you the file, but it is not accepting my resubmission because the due date was on the 9th of January. But I find another thing like I checked my drive was saved there and the due dates are right in there. So if you wanted, I can share my screen with you and then check my paper.
You can also send it by the way. There is a resubmission. Yeah, there is a resubmission in the Google Classroom. Okay, try to resubmit.
So I resubmitted. If you check right now, if you have a
resubmitted, and I will check it, and definitely I will deduct some marks from you. But I want you to be aware that for the final and for the midterm exams, there should be all the same way. So if you have a problem now, it's better to check it and to solve that problem now.
And I will do so, sir. I'll be more careful from now on because I submitted this one, but unfortunately it is not submitted.
I will check it again, and if any else, I will write it to you, okay?
Okay, thank you, sir.
Bye.
Thank you for your time.
Okay, bye-bye.